In this video, I'll show you how to add estimated delivery date on your Shopify product page. Just like this. Right above the Add to Cart button, you see a sleek delivery widget.
My name is Oliver, and I'm from Netscale. In this video, I'll walk you through three simple steps, with each one taking your product page to the next level. So make sure to follow them all. Now, let's get started.
So the first step is installing the app Netscale Estimated Delivery Date. Now, we'll go to the app section. In the search bar, type the keyword Netscale Estimated Delivery Date and click on search in the Shopify App Store. You should see the app showing up. Click on it. Then, click on install. From this page, hit Install App in the bottom right corner. And that's it! Netscale Estimated Delivery Date is now installed on your store. Now the app's been installed, the next step is to show the estimated delivery date on your Shopify product page. Here's how to do it. You'll land on this dashboard where you see a quick 3-step checklist. The first one is Adblock. So let's start with that. I'll click on Adblock and it automatically takes to the Shopify theme editor, specifically to the default product page. Here you can preview which product the delivery date will appear on. In this case, we're looking at a base product. On the left sidebar, scroll down to the template section and look for apps. Hover over it and click Adblock. Then, under the Apps tab, select Netscale EDD product. That's the Estimate Delivery Date widget. You'll see it pop up live on the page, right below the Buy It Now button. Super clean and modern. You can drag it to place it wherever fits your layout best. Maybe under the title, next to the brands. But for me, I think just above the Add to Cart is perfect. That's where customers make decisions. And this info can really nudge them to complete the purchase. Just click on the Save button to complete embedding. Now that the widget is placed on the product page, let's customize how it looks and what it says. First, head back to the Netscale Estimate Delivery Date dashboard and click on Global Rules in the left-hand sidebar. In this section controls the default settings for all products on your store. And inside it, we'll start customizing the text message that appears above your timeline. By default, the app says free shipping to country name and country flag, and the preview panel on the right shows you exactly how this will look. So if just someone is shopping from Singapore, it say free shipping to Singapore. Pretty neat already. But let's take it a step further. Let's make this message even more helpful and specific. I'll try something like free shipping between, and here where it gets cool. Right below the text bar, you see these quick insert buttons. Delivery date minimum, max, ready date minimum, and cutoff time. Let's use delivery date minimum and max, and now the message becomes free shipping between 19 April and 26th of April to Singapore. Or if you want your customers to act fast, you can add a sense of urgency using the cutoff time variable. Try something like order in the next cutoff time for same day delivery. This is perfect for stores that ship daily and want to motivate faster purchases. You can also tweak how the message looks. The font to make it bigger for more visibility, update the highlight or text color, or even add emojis for extra flair. Down below is the visual settings section. This is where you can customize how your order delivery progress appears. First up, we have the layout mode. You can choose between three display options: progress bar only, message text only, or progress bar and message together. I usually recommend keeping both though. Now, let's talk colors. You can change the status text color, date text color, icon, and even the background color of the progress stages. And want to change the wording of each delivery stage? You can do that too. Just scroll to the bottom of the visual settings and you'll find inputs for ordered, order ready, and delivered. You can rename these to really match your tone. For example, turn order ready into packing in progress or shipment schedule. Further down, you'll see date format settings. If you're selling internationally, you might want to switch from the US format to days first and then month second. And if you're running a multilingual store, just update the language code. We have plenty of options here. Once you're happy with the layout, colors, and spacing, don't forget to hit that save button in the top right. There's one last step that can make your delivery estimates even more accurate, especially if you sell internationally. Scroll down to the time zone settings section. By default, you can manually choose your store time zone. But if you want the delivery widget to automatically adjust based on your visitor countries, just toggle on the switch Automatic Conversion Time Zone. This way, your cutoff times and date ranges will always make sense, whether your customers in London, LA, or Tokyo. Down below is the out of stock messages. This section lets you display a short note when an item is sold out, like currently out of stock or back soon. It only appears on sold out products and you can easily turn it on or off with the toggle. The first step is to configure the estimated delivery date logic for your store. Switch to the tab labeled Estimated Delivery Time and start selecting your working days. Just tick the boxes for the day your team works and your courier delivers. For example, mine doesn't do on Sundays or Saturday, so I'll untick those days. Then, set your order ready range and order delivery range using the sliders. So I'll change the first one to 1 or 2 days and the delivery to 4 to 3 days. Once everything looks good, hit save. But hey, let's take it a step further with these next two features, holiday settings and cutoff times. First up is holidays. Scroll down and toggle on the holiday section. Then I'll hit plus add date. Then a pop-up will appear. Type in the holiday name and select the exact date from the calendar. Click done and that's it. Next up is cutoff time. If you want to encourage faster purchases or have strict same-day fulfillment window, this is where cutoff time shines. I'll usually choose mine, for example, 16 p.m. or 20 p.m. What if you want a different estimate delivery date setup for specific collections during seasonal promos, limited editions, or bundles? That's where collection rules come in handy. When you click Add Collection Rule, you see two options. You can either sync with an existing Shopify collection, which is automatic and pulls in all the products already grouped on the store, or you can manually build your own collection by selecting these products one by one. In this case, I'm using the first option and choosing one of my Shopify collections called Seasonal Grace. Once selected, everything inside that collection will follow the custom delivery logic I set up here. The setup screen is exactly what we did earlier with global rules. And if you want to go even deeper, let's say one specific product needs a totally different schedule, you can do that too with product rules. Product rules let you override all the other settings and apply a custom delivery timeline to individual items, perfect for cases like made-to-order products, high-demand launches, or anything that doesn't fit your standard fulfillment flow. Now that we've successfully added the estimated delivery date to our Shopify product page, let's talk about 3 more powerful features inside the Netscale EDD app. First of which is showing the same delivery estimate on your cart and checkout pages. Why this awesome? Because Shopify built-in checkout messages don't dynamically show when a customer will receive that order. Now, if you're shipping internationally or handing orders across multiple regions, the next feature is a game changer, delivery country. This lets you set a specific delivery time for each destination country, so your visitors will always see the timeline that actually matches where they're located. Now, moving on. If your store runs in more than one language, use the language configuration feature. This lets you customize your delivery message for different languages based on your customer browser settings or preferred language.
And that's a wrap, fellas. Just build a fully customized, high converting estimated delivery date system right inside your Shopify store. If you found this video helpful, well, give it a thumbs up. And if you're really serious about leveling up your store experience, go right ahead and install Netscale Estimated Delivery Date now. And if you want to take your product page even further, like adding beautiful color swatches and customizing it, well, I recommend you check out my other tutorials right up here. Well, that's it for this video. Bye-bye.